So keyword cannibalization occurs when multiple pages on your website target the same keyword or similar variations. For example, you have this page that targets the keyword Rank Math Content AI Review. And when Content AI has upgraded to version 2, instead of working on the existing content, you started a new article targeting the same keyword, Rank Math Content AI Review, but you added a 2.0 in it. So now you have multiple pages targeting the same keyword with the same meaning and same search intent, and this is what we call keyword cannibalization, and it is not good for SEO. So in this video, let us show you how to find and fix keyword cannibalization issues. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from Rank Math, the one tool that brings you easy-to-use SEO and AI tools, and this channel provides you with tips, tricks, and tutorials to grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. And now let's go a little deeper into understanding what is and what is not keyword cannibalization. So the simple definition of keyword cannibalization is two or more different pages trying to rank for the same keyword. But what if those pages have different search intent? For example, page A targets the keyword best free WordPress SEO tools, and it is an informational article comparing different WordPress SEO tools. And page B targets the same keyword, best free WordPress SEO tools, but it is the homepage of Rank Math, and the keyword is its slogan. So this page has a transactional intent. In this case, it is not considered keyword cannibalization because they have different search intent. You've got to understand the difference. And with that, let's figure out how to find keyword cannibalization issues. Now, the problem with keyword cannibalization issues is that it happens subtly. There is no clear evidence pointing you towards the issue. However, you may have observed that the rankings for an important keyword is unstable or fluctuate between different pages on your site, or if the click-through rate of an important page is getting lower and lower. It calls for a check on keyword cannibalization. Now, there are a couple of ways you can identify that. First is the use of none other than good old Google. Simply type in site colon, and then without leaving any spaces, type in your domain name without the HTTPS protocol, for example, shopify.com, and then space in title colon to find similar keywords in the title, and then the keyword you suspect to be cannibalized, for example, how to set up an online store. Keep a lookout on this code. If you code the keyword, it means you are trying to find titles on your website that have the same exact keyword in the same order. For example, the result of this is that it has two pages that contain the same keyword, how to set up an online store. The same goes for this, in the same exact order. However, if you remove the quotes, you will get more results because it is a broad match, where we find pages on your site that have each individual keyword, like setup and its nuances, like start, launch, etc. Both methods has its pros and cons. With quotes, you will get more accurate results as to which pages are competing against each other. For example, in this sense, there is a clear keyword cannibalization issue. And as an SEO for Shopify, you may need to consider which page packs more SEO value and solve the cannibalization, which we'll talk about in a while. However, it is a good idea to search for the keyword without quotes. And from there, try to see if there are pages competing for the same keyword in the title. For example, how to start an online store in 2024, step-by-step guide. And if you scroll down further, you will find e-commerce basics, how to set up your online store 2024. So these are practically two different pages trying to rank for the same keyword and have the same informational search intent. So with both the quotes and no quotes on a keyword, it can review pages with keyword cannibalization issues. Now, another way to find the issues is by using the Google Search Console. On your Search Console, you want to visit the Performance tab and change the date range to between 6 to 12 months for more accurate results. And then if you have already suspected some keywords having that issue, you can click on this to add a new filter, select query, and then filter queries containing the suspected keyword. For example, in my case, is Dior cruelty free, and hit apply. These are the keywords. If I click on one of them, and I want to know what page or pages are ranking for this keyword, I'll switch it to pages. And if I see two pages here trying to rank for the keyword, and two of them are serving the same search intent, then you have found the issue. Then to confirm there is a keyword cannibalization issue, you want to check the average rankings of the pages. If there is a clear sign of dropping or fluctuating in positions over a period, then there is an issue. You need to fix it. Another way to find keyword cannibalization issues is to simply use RankMath's keyword tracking tool in the analytics module. Go to the Rank Tracker tab, and here are all the keywords you are tracking. If you have not set this up and your list is empty, feel free to click on this Auto Add Focus Keywords button and toggle the post types where most of your rankable content lives. And as you save settings, you should be able to see a list of keywords added. That's because RankMath automatically adds the primary focus keywords you have added to the post or pages. These are keywords you want your page to rank anyway. So with this, sort the keywords based on their impressions. If there are pages that are important to your site or business, you want to do this as well. Click on the keyword, and this will tell you if there are multiple pages ranking for this keyword. In this case, there is only one page ranking for this keyword, so there is no cannibalization issue. But if you see multiple pages here, then you've got to fix them. Alright, there are multiple ways to fix keyword cannibalization. Let's start with this. This solution requires you to combine all pages that are competing for the same keyword into one comprehensive page.
Imagine you have two pages, page A and B, both targeting the keyword healthy smoothie recipes. You want to analyze the SEO factors of both pages and choose one with the most quality backlinks, rankings, and traffic as the primary page. Let's say that it is page A. Then combine valuable contents from page B into page A to make page A more comprehensive and valuable. And finally, add a 301 redirect from page B to page A to transfer all SEO value previously accumulated from page B into page A. To do 301 redirects, if you have RankMath installed on your WordPress site, on its dashboard, you need to make sure that the redirections module is turned on. And then you want to visit the redirections module. In this module, you can manage all the redirections at one place. And to create a new redirect, click on Add New. Let's say that the URL of page B is this. You would add it to the source URL field. And then the URL of page A is this. You would add it as the destination URL. After which, you want to select the 301 permanent move to tell search engines that this page has permanently moved to this page. And all the past SEO value accumulated, like the backlinks and everything from this page, should be equated to this page. And then keep the status as active and create the redirection. And you're basically done.
Now, if you don't want to consolidate pages and you want all the pages to be live on your site, then the second way is to add canonical tags to lower priority pages.
Similar to the previous solution, you have to decide on one page to be the primary page, and you have to tell search engines to focus on this page when ranking for the keyword by adding canonical tags on the other pages. Assuming page A is the page with higher priority, and page B and C are pages with lower priority, with RankMath, all you need to do is to visit the lower priority pages. Let's start with page B. Go to the RankMath SEO tab, and under the Advanced tab, you will see a canonical URL field. By default, all pages are self-canonicalized, which means the canonical URL is the same URL of the page. This is a good SEO practice. But to tell search engines not to focus on this page when ranking for the keyword, you want to add the URL of the primary page here. Save it, and that's basically it.
This solution is highly effective for e-commerce product pages with different filters like different colors and attributes, but all the pages target the same keyword. With canonical tags added, search engines will focus on one main page to rank the keyword. Now, this solution works in situations where two pages with distinct content and angles happen to rank for the same keyword.
For example, page A focuses on vegan dessert recipes, while page B focuses on low-calorie dessert recipes. Both started ranking for the keyword healthy dessert recipes. Now, since both contents are different and have different angles, you want to leverage on the anchor tags of other pages on your site that are internally linked to these pages. For example, maybe you have used the anchor tags healthy dessert recipes on both page C and D, and they are linked to the two cannibalized pages. So what you want to do is to change the anchor text of page C to vegan dessert recipes as well as low calorie dessert recipes on page D.
That's for just one instance, but you want to analyze the anchor text of all pages that are linking to those two cannibalized pages and optimize them accordingly. Now, this depends on the context of the cannibalized keyword. If the same keyword could have different meaning in a broader context, you would use this solution.
For example, page A and page B both rank for the keyword digital marketing strategies. The title of page A is top 10 digital marketing strategies with no clear targeting. And the title of page B is advanced digital marketing strategies for e-commerce. Some content on page B overlaps significantly with page A, and that caused the keyword cannibalization. In this case, you may want to rewrite or revamp the content on page A to target beginners with the title amended to Beginner's Guide to Digital Marketing Strategies. And you give definition of digital marketing, basic strategies such as SEO, content marketing, etc., tips for small businesses, or basically any strategies beginners can adopt. And for page B, you want to revamp your content to focus on advanced techniques like AI marketing, automation and analytics, add case studies and examples specific to e-commerce, in-depth analysis of strategies, technical jargon and detailed guides suitable for experienced marketers. Doing this will make clear distinctions to search engines, telling them that these two pages are serving different audiences. So let's say that both page A and B have the title Best Laptops and Best Laptops Guide. Page A is a mix of general reviews and some product recommendations and has the commercial search intent, and the content on page B overlaps with page A with the same search intent, but it provides more guides than review. In this case, you can optimize page A to Best Laptops of 2024 Compared, where you focus on providing side-by-side comparisons between different laptops, pros and cons of each laptop, etc., which keeps the original commercial search intent. And then for page B, you want to optimize the page to be more informational, such as the ultimate guide to finding the best laptops, where you will give general buying guides for various types of users, tips and FAQs on choosing the best laptop, and the search intent of this page will be transformed to informational.
So these are the 5 solutions for keyword cannibalization. If you have any questions, feel free to let us know by leaving a comment down below, and don't forget to smash that thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to us, do so, because we are all about helping you grow your search traffic. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.